Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Buona sifiwe.
And this afternoon I'll talk about how to raise up people to serve God.
Ajioni leo tunaenda kuzungumzia jinsi unaweza kuinua watu kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Bwana.
How to raise up people in your church or the people around you that they love God more and then serve God.
Jinsi unaweza kuinua watu kanisani mahali unahudumu kwamba wakaweze kuwa watu ambao wanaweza kumtumikia Mungu wakati wowote.
I will first talk about what we look for in people and then and the process of helping them to serve God.
Tutazungumzia jinsi kile unaweza kutazama ndani ya mtu ndiposa ukaanze kumuinua kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Mungu.
And then I'll give you the Bible passages to encourage people to serve God.
Na tutawapatia funzo la Biblia ambavyo vinaweza kukuelekeza kuongoza watu kwa kumtumikia Bwana.
The first part is very important that we look for people who have the heart.
Jambo la kwanza la muhimu kwamba tunaangalia watu walio na moyo.
Now for myself, I help people spiritually all the time.
Kwangu mimi, yeye anasema kwamba anasaidia watu kwa kiwango kingine.
Now, sometimes it could be a non-Christian, I pray for them and lead them to Christ.
Saingine huwa nawaongoza, ninawaompea na kuwaongoza kwa Yesu.
Okay, now, there are people who ask me, they bring a non-Christians to me and to pray for them or to bring them to believe in Jesus.
Watu wengi ukuja kwangu na maswali, ninawajibu na kuwaongoza kwa ajili ya kumjua Yesu.
As soon as I pray for them,
ninapokuwa kwamba nimeshawaombea,
and tell them how wonderful God is,
ninapowaambia kwamba jinsi Mungu alivyo wa ajabu,
I always tell them, God is so good.
Ninawaambia kwamba Mungu ni mwema kabisa.
You can experience His peace, His presence, His love and joy.
Naweza kushuhudia upendo wake, amani yake na furaha yake iliyo timilivu.
Now if we build up a strong anointing of the Holy Spirit,
na tunapojengwa katika msingi ulio wa nguvu wa kiroho,
this is something we all can pursue.
Hili ni jambo ambalo sisi wote tunaweza kulifuatilia.
It's not difficult if you love the Lord.
Sio jambo ngumu iwapo wewe unampenda Yesu.
It is difficult if you don't have a close relationship with God.
Inakuwa tu ngumu iwapo wewe hauna uhusiano wa karibu na Mungu.
And God is willing to give you anointing.
Mungu anatamania sana kukupatia upako.
He wants to use you greatly.
Anataka kukutumikia kwa njia kuu.
So if you really love God,
iwapo unampenda Bwana ndani ya moyo wako,
and see that God is blessing us all the time,
na kuona kwamba Mungu anakubariki kila wakati,
and desire to love, respond to His love,
na utamani kuitikia kwa ajili ya upendo wake,
and appreciate God all the time,
na kumshuhudia Bwana kila wakati,
everything I see, I think of God.
Kila chochote ninachokiona huwa ninafikiria juu ya Mungu.
I saw two birds building nests out there on the tree.
Ameona ndege zikijenga kiota hapa nje.
I want to videotape them on the trees, building a nest on the tree.
Na akachukua video yake, akaanza kuchukua vile hizo ndege zilikuwa zinajenga.
What I saw is God has the wisdom to create a bird.
Kile alichoona ni kwamba Mungu ako na hekima ya kuumba ndege,
and teach them how to build a nest.
Na kuzifundisha jinsi zinaweza kujenga nyumba zao.
No one trained the birds how to build a nest.
Hakuna mtu aliyefundisha ndege kujenga kiota chake na mdomo.
But they can do it.
Lakini wanaweza kufanya mambo hayo.
Now this also shows the love of God.
Hiyo pia inadhihirisha upendo mkuu wa Mungu.
The food we eat, we can see the love of God.
Chakula ile tumekula jioni mchana huu inaweza kudhihirisha pia upendo wa Mungu.
God created food so delicious.
Mungu aliumba chakula kiwe tamu.
So all day long I say, God, you're so good.
Kila wakati ninasema kwamba Mungu wewe ni mwema wa mwaminifu.
Always appreciate God.
Kila kitu ninapohubiri Mungu,
and enjoy His presence,
na kufurahia uwepo wake,
I spend time concentrating in the prayer to Him.
Ninachukua muda wangu kwa ajili ya kuweka mawazo yangu kwa ajili ya maombi.
Also when I'm doing other things, I think about Jesus all the time.
Na kila chochote ninachokifanya huwa ninafikiria juu ya Mungu kila wakati.
Even now, when I'm preaching, I'll be, you know, I have the heart to like God.
Hata wakati huu anapohubiri, ana moyo wa kumsikia juu ya Mungu na kumpenda.
When you have that close relationship with the Lord,
iwapo uko na huo uhusiano wa karibu na Mungu,
the anointing of the Holy Spirit will be upon you.
Upako wa Roho wa Mungu utakuwa juu yako wewe.
You notice just now I pray for the people here.
Sio tu kuombea watu hapa.
Everyone experienced the Holy Spirit.
Kila mmoja anashuhudia ukuu wa Mungu.
And this is something we all can pursue.
Hii ni kitu ambacho sisi wote tunaweza kufuatilia.
So when I meet a non-Christian,
kwa hivyo ninapokutana na watu ambao sio wa Kristo,
I will first tell him God is good.
Namwambia ya kwanza Mungu ni mwema, Mungu ni mzuri.
God cares about you.
Mungu anakujali wewe.
And you can experience God.
Na unaweza kushuhudia Mungu.
And you can experience the blessings of God.
Na unaweza kushuhudia pia baraka za Mungu.
And I ask him, are you willing that I pray for you to experience his presence?
Na ninamuuliza, je, unatamani kwamba nikuombee kwamba ukaweze kushuhudia ukuu wa Mungu?
And then he says he's willing.
Na yeye anasema kwamba anatamani.
And then I say, open your heart.
Na ninamwambia kwamba fungua moyo wako.
Believe that God is blessing you right
amini
now.
Amini kwamba Mungu anakubariki kuanzia wakati huu.
And I noticed that 95% of the people I pray for.
Na ninatambua kwamba 95% kwa watu wale ambao mimi ninawaombea.
If they open the heart to God.
Wanapofungua mioyo yao kwa ajili ya Bwana.
Would experience a peace or the burdens go away.
Watashuhudia amani na furaha ya Bwana ndani ya mioyo yao.
Or love or joy.
Na upendo na ufurati milivu.
Or power of God.
Hata nguvu za Mungu.
And you too can, you know, do this.
Na hata nyinyi pia mnaweza kufanya mambo haya.
And when you spend time loving God.
Na mnapochukua muda wenu kwa ajili ya kumpenda Bwana.
And spend time praying for people.
Na kuchukua muda wa kutosha kwa ajili ya kuombea watu.
And also ask them, have they experienced anything?
Na umuulize kama pia wameshuhudia jambo lolote.
It's a chance to strengthen their faith.
Niyo ni njia ya kujenga imani.
And tell them God has blessed you.
Na kuambia kwamba Mungu atakubariki.
So do you want Jesus to continue bless you?
Kwa hivyo unamuuliza kwamba unataka Mungu aendelee kukubariki wewe.
And then if they are willing.
Na kama wanajisikia ni sawa.
I bring them to believe in Jesus.
Ninawaleta kwa ajili ya kuamini Yesu.
And follow Jesus.
Na kumfuata Yesu.
And then if they say yes I'm willing.
Na wanaposema kwamba hey tunasikia sawa.
I start to disciple them.
Ninaanza kuwafundisha huduma.
I said the presence of God is strong upon you.
Naambia kwamba uwepo wa Mungu huko na nguvu kwa ajili yako.
He'll continue bless you.
Yeye ataendelea kukubariki.
He'll use your life mightily.
Atatumia maisha yako kwa njia kuu.
When you're willing to be used by God.
Unapojisikia kutumika na Mungu.
You can bless many people.
Utaweza kubariki watu wengi pia.
You can pray for the sick and they be healed.
Unaweza kuombea wagonjwa na wapone.
And then unless people who are sad can be free.
Na watu ambao wako na uchungu ndani ya mioyo yao wanaweza kufunguliwa.
Are you willing to serve God?
Na ujisikia kumtumikia Bwana?
Of course, first I ask them if they are willing to love God and then I ask them to.
Jambo la kwanza nauliza kama wako tayari kumpenda Mungu, ndio niwaulize kama wako tayari kumtumikia Mungu.
Now some people respond to God right away.
Watu wengi huitikia Mungu haraka iwezekanavyo.
I never give up the chance to challenge people.
Huwa sipeani nafasi kwa ajili ya kupeana changamoto kwa watu.
Actually, you notice when Jesus invite people?
Unajua kwamba Yesu anapoalika watu?
Come follow me.
Njoo unifuate.
So he did not just say believe, follow me.
Hawaambii tu kwamba muamini, bali anawaambia kwamba muamini.
And then he said to Peter, you'll be a catcher of men.
Naye akamwambia Petro kwamba utakuwa mvuvi wa watu.
After he called him.
Baada ya kumuita.
So for non-Christians and then for Christians too.
Kwa ajili ya wasio wa Kristo na wa Kristo pia.
I pray for every Christians in my group.
Ninaombea kila kikundi katika huduma wangu.
And also there are other Christians who come to me for help.
Kuna maswali mengine ambayo yatakuja kwangu kwa ajili ya usaidizi.
And then I'll tell them God is very good.
Nitawaambia kwamba Mungu ni mwema wa ajabu.
He can change your life.
Anaweza kubadilisha maisha yako.
He can take away your burdens.
Anaweza kutolea mizigo zako.
And he'll be with you all the time.
Naye
pray to him all the time.
Atakuwa pamoja na wewe kila wakati wowote.
And so, and then I say, do you want to have a close relationship with God?
Nawauliza wataka kuwa na uhusiano ulio karibu na Mungu.
And then if they're willing, you know, also I pray for them to experience the Holy Spirit.
Iwapo wanajisikia, ninawaombea kwamba pia wao wakaweze kuhisi uwepo wa Mungu.
So I said to him, God come to bless you in such a real way.
Anawaambia kwamba Mungu ameshuka kwamba akuweze kukubariki kwa njia kuu namna hii.
You can bless other people.
Unaweza kubariki watu wengine pia.
Are you willing to love God more?
Unajisikia kumpenda Mungu zaidi hapo?
And serve God more.
Na kumtumikia Mungu zaidi?
And then if he's willing,
na kama anajisikia,
I start to disciple him.
Ninaanza kumfundisha kuwa mwanafunzi.
and train him to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
Na kumfundisha ajaswe na nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu.
Train him how to counsel people.
Kumfundisha jinsi anaweza kupeana mashauri kwa watu.
How to do evangelism.
Vile anaweza kufanya uinjilisti.
How to pray for people.
Vile anaweza kuombea watu.
And also teach them how to take care of problems in their life.
Na pia kuwafundisha jinsi wanaweza kujiondolea shida katika maisha yao.
So that they are joyful all the time.
Kwamba kila wakati wawe na furaha iliyotimilifu.
That we can enjoy God's presence.
Kwamba tunaweza kushuhudia uwepo wa Mungu katikati yetu.
And then if they're willing,
na iwapo wanajisikia,
I'll see how they are doing.
Nitaona vile wanavyofanya.
Some people say yes, I'm willing.
Watu wengine husema kwamba ndio ninajisikia.
But they don't do it.
Lakini hawafanyi.
And they continue to be burdened by the problems.
Wanaendelea kufinyiliwa na shida na matatizo.
But there are some people who are willing.
Kuna watu wengine ambao wanaitikia na kweli wanajisikia kwamba wanaweza kumtumikia Mungu.
Then my eyes will be on these people.
Na macho yangu itaangalia hawa watu.
You notice that Jesus chose the 12 disciples.
Ndio wakati Yesu alichagua wanafunzi wale 12.
There are many people who follow him.
Kuna watu wengi waliomfuata.
He did not choose everybody.
Hakuchagua kila mtu.
So he prayed overnight and then God guided him to choose the 12 disciples.
Aliomba usiku wote naye Mungu akamuongoza kuchagua wale 12.
So to raise up leaders is very important.
Kwa hivyo kuinua viongozi ni jambo lililo la maana la muhimu sana.
And I keep having communication with these people who are willing to serve God.
Ninaendelea kuwa na uhusiano na mawasiliano na hao watu walio tayari kumtumikia Bwana.
And I give them opportunities to serve God.
Na ninawapatia nafasi za kumtumikia Bwana.
For instance, every, you know, Monday when my meeting is in Hong Kong.
Kwa mfano Jumatatu mkutano wangu ukiwa kule Hong Kong.
When there are people who ask for help, I tell them to come at 4 p.m. for prayer.
Iwapo kuna watu ambao wana mahitaji, ninawaambia kwamba wakuje saa 10 ya jioni.
And the meeting starts at 7 p.m.
Nae mkutano unaanza saa 1 kamili.
But I start praying for people at 4.
Lakini ninaanza kuombea watu saa 10.
And then at 5:30 I give a time that the people practice sharing or giving messages.
Ikifika saa 11:30 napeana watu waanze kutoa ushuhuda na kuwasiliana kwa jambo moja ama lingine.
Or praying for people.
Ama kuombea watu.
And then I have a group of people who are willing to come back at 4 p.m. and start praying for the people.
Na kuna watu ambao wanajisikia kwamba wanaweza kukuja saa 10 na waanze kuomba pamoja na watu.
Or to counsel people.
Ama kupeana mashauri kwa watu.
So I give them opportunities to serve God.
Kwa hivyo ninawapatia nafasi za kumtumikia Bwana.
And then in my meeting there's training on ministry.
Na katika huduma wake kuna idara ya mafundisho.
In the last part about from 9 to 10 p.m. there's also practice of doing ministry.
There is
9 p.m. to 10 p.m.
Kuanzia saa 9 mpaka saa 10 kuna idara ya mafundisho.
So I first spot these people.
Kwanza anafundisha hawa watu.
And then I give them training.
Anawapatia mafundisho.
And then I communicate with them about their life.
Ninawasiliana na wao juu ya maisha.
I ask them to give me report on how they handle problem in their life.
Ninawauliza waweze kuchangia mawazo vile wanavyo tatua shida katika maisha yao.
So they send with WhatsApp about how they handle the negative emotions.
Na wanatuma katika mtandao vile wanavyo suluhisha mambo ambayo ni yana changamoto katika maisha.
How they handle the sins.
Vile wanavyo endelea tatua mambo ya dhambi.
And how they handle different problems in their life.
Na vile wanavyo tatua mambo tafauti tafauti katika maisha yao.
And then when I look at, you know, how they share about how they handle the problems.
Napo angalia vile wanavyo shiriki, vile wanavyo tatua matatizo yao.
I might respond to them and help them to take care of the problems more.
Ninaitikia na kuwashauri vile wanaweza kuendelea.
I also pray for them to check out whether they have evil spirit or not.
Ninawaombea iwapo wana roho chafu ama hapana.
After a while, I set them free to pray for people.
Baada hiyo ninawaachilia uhuru kwamba wakaweze kusaidia watu.
And to counsel people.
Na kushauri watu.
And to do evangelism.
Na kufanya uinjilisti.
And also when I'm in Hong Kong, I bring people to the mission field close to Hong Kong.
Anapokuwa kwa kule Hong Kong, huwa analeta watu katika uwanja wa umishonari kule Hong Kong.
When we go there, I give them opportunities to serve God.
Anapokuwa kwa mako kule, anawapatia nafasi kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Mungu.
So my ministry is always raising up people to serve God.
Kwa hivyo huduma ambayo anafanya nayo kazi kila wakati unainua watu kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Bwana.
And I see how they are responding.
Na anaona vile wanavyoitikia.
I also evaluate what they do.
Anaangalia kile wanafanya.
That way I'll be raising up people to serve God all the time.
Kwa hivyo kila wakati atakuwa anainua watu kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Mungu.
So when you have a church,
kwa hivyo iwapo wewe ni mchungaji uko hapa, kambe muhudumu kwa kanisa lano,
I encourage you not to think of your ministry as just preaching the word.
Usifikirie tu huduma yako juu ya kuhubiri injili kila wakati.
And have a Bible study.
Na kuwa na masomo ya Biblia.
And pray for the people.
Na kuombea watu.
And then send them home.
Na kuwatuma waende nyumbani.
Because when we do that,
kwa sababu tunapofanya mambo kama hayo,
every time they're just receiving help.
Kila wakati watakuwa wanapata tu usaidizi, utasaidizi kila wakati.
They always come to us and say, I'm sick, I'm not feeling well, pray for me.
Hey, watu wakikuja tu nikusema tu, pastor, oh, mimi ni mgonjwa na uniombe yangi.
And then what happened is, then they just want help.
Sasa kile kitu wao wanataka ni kusaidiwa tu.
But we want people not just to look for help.
Hatutaki watu tu waweze kutafuta usaidizi katika kanisa la Bwana.
I want people to, after they are helped, they want to bless other people.
Taka watu kwamba baada ya watu kusaidiwa na waende wasaidie watu wengine.
Because Jesus called us all to be servants.
Kwa sababu Yesu alituita sisi wote kwamba tuwe watumishi.
If I am a pastor and has many people in the church.
Kiwa mimi ni mchungaji na niko na watu wengi kuliko wale wako hapa hivi.
And a pastor has brought many people to Christ.
Naye mchungaji analeta watu wengi kwa ajili ya Kristo.
But the members just come every week to listen to the sermon.
Na washirika wanakuja tu kila siku kusikia mahubiri.
And they don't serve God.
Na watumikii Mungu.
One day when they stand in front of Jesus.
Watakaposimama mbele ya Yesu.
Jesus asks them, "What have you brought for me?"
Yesu atawauliza swali kwamba mlipokuwa kwa huduma.
In Chinese, they may say two bunches of bananas. That means empty-handed. I bring you two bunches of bananas. That's all I have. Who is a faithful pastor?
Mchungaji aliye mwaminifu ni mgani?
A faithful pastor is one who sees the potential in each person.
Mchungaji mzuri ni yule anayeona majukumu yaliyo ndani ya watu.
And raise them up to serve God.
Na kuwainua kwa ajili ya kutumika.
Now, people can do different things.
Watu wanaweza kufanya vitu vilivyo tofauti.
There are some people who are capable to be leaders.
Kuna watu wengine ambao wako na uwezo wa kuwa viongozi.
Yes. There are people who can just do some simple things in a church.
Kuna watu wengine ambao wanaweza kufanya tu ingawa wana mambo bosi nje fulani wanyi.
But it doesn't matter.
Lakini ni jambo la kufanya tu katika huduma.
If we encourage them that what they do Jesus is happy with.
Kile tunawaonyesha kwamba kile wanachokifanya Mungu anafurahia.
And then if they can be leaders, they become leaders.
Na wanapokuwa kwamba sasa wamekuwa viongozi, wanakuwa viongozi.
And then people who can do simple works.
Na wale ambao wanaweza kufanya kazi iliyo kazi rahisi.
I still train them to do the simple work.
Ninawafundisha tu waendelee kufanya hiyo kazi rahisi.
But I encourage them to go higher.
Lakini ninawafundisha kwamba waweze kusonga juu.
Yes.
At the same time I see the potential of each person.
Na kila huwa wakati wanapofanya hiyo ninaona kila mtu anaweza kufanya.
I also look at the inner qualities.
Ninaangalia vile vipaji vya ndani.
Some people have compassion on people.
Watu wengine wana huruma na watu.
And you can see that.
Na unaweza kuona hiyo wazi.
Because you see them care for other people.
Sababu unaona watu wakishughulikia watu.
I can see that they really put the heart to help other people.
Wanakuwa na ule moyo wa kusaidia watu wengine.
Now, and then some people do the ministry.
Na watu wengine hufanya huduma.
But they might not have much motivation. They don't have much motivation.
Oho, na hawana hali ya kuinuliwa juu.
Or when they do it, they want glory for themselves.
Na wanapofanya kwa watu wengine, wanakuwa kwamba wanataka wajione kwamba hao ndio wanaweza.
Then I would talk with them.
Nitaongea na wao.
I would build them up.
Nitawajenga.
Tell them they are important.
Niwaambie kwamba wana muhimu, wana maana.
God wants to use you greatly.
Mungu anataka kuwatumikia zaidi.
And we all build on the foundation of Jesus Christ.
Na sisi wote tuwe kwa msingi wa Yesu Kristo.
When we are building on it.
Tunapojenga juu ya msingi huu.
If we have pride,
iwapo tuko na kiburi,
or sins,
ama tuko na dhambi,
then we're tearing down on what we are building.
Sasa Yesu atakuwa anatushusha chini mahali tunapojenga.
You know, I talk about that in the teachings.
Nasungumuza hayo nikiwa kwa mafundisho.
So people know that it's not just serving.
Watu wanajua kwamba sio kutumika tu.
It's very important that they take care of problems in their life.
Ni ya muhimu tena kwamba waweze kuchukua nafasi ndani ya maisha yao.
And really want to bless people.
Na watake wawe na tamaa ya kubariki.
Not for their own glory.
Sio kwa utukufu wao wenyewe.
Not for them to be liked by people.
Sio kwamba ati watu wakupende waone wewe ndio unafaa.
But we really want God's will done.
Kwamba mapenzi ya Mungu yakaweze kutendeka.
So I see qualities of people.
Sasa anaona umuhimu ulio ndani ya kila mtu.
Their inner qualities.
Zile za ndani.
Their spiritual gifts.
Na zile za kiroho.
Their ability to serve.
Na ile tamaa ya kutumika.
And then I would try to help them to go as far as they can to serve God.
Ninawasaidia kwamba wakaweze kuinuka kiwango kile wataweza kufika.
When people can go a certain level,
watu wanapoenda kwa kiwango kingine,
I encourage them, challenge them to go a high level.
Ninawatia moyo na kuwapatia mafundisho zaidi ili waende kwa kiwango ya juu.
And I'm not afraid to give my responsibilities to people.
Na sina uoga wa kupatia majukumu yangu, nipatie mtu niseme kwamba wewe utafanya majukumu yangu.
For instance, I look for people to preach for me when I'm away on mission trips.
Sana sana huwa naangalia watu ambao wanaweza kuhubiri kwa sababu sasa hivi ako hapa Kenya na kanisa liko huko. Anajua watu wale wanaweza kuhubiri wakati yeye hayuko.
I'm not jealous of people who can do a good job.
Sio mtu tu kwamba ati mtu ule anaweza kufanya kazi nzuri.
I'm happy to raise them up.
Anafurahia wakati anapowainua juu.
Now even people who contact me on the internet.
Na hata katika mtandao watu humpatia matokeo ya kazi.
They could be living in different countries.
Wanaweza kuwa wanaishi nje tofauti.
I still help them spiritually.
Na ninawasaidia katika huduma ya kiroho.
Because I want to bless the kingdom of God.
Sababu ninataka kubariki huduma wa ufalme wa Mungu.
Not just people in my group.
Sio watu tu ambao wako karibu na mimi.
My heart is if I bless people.
Moyo wangu ni kwamba ninapowabariki watu.
God is happy with that.
Mungu anafurahia jambo hilo.
And I can bless the kingdom of God.
Na mimi ninaweza kubariki ufalme wa Mungu.
So wherever I go I see people I try to help them.
Kwa hivyo kila mahali ninapoenda ninaona watu kwamba nimejaribu kuwasaidia.
And you know, in this process, I'm able to raise up people to serve God.
Kwa hivyo katika mpangilio hii, niko na uwezo wa kuinua watu kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Mungu.
Now, before I go any further,
kabla sijaendelea sana,
do you have any question about what I just said?
Amakuwa kaya kabola kana areva anga maumua kwa nili reva numzi anuaji.
What I just said is how I, after I pray for people or share the message with them, immediately I start to encourage them to serve God.
Amesema haya mambo yenye amesungumuza, amekuwa amekizungumzia tu jinsi watu wanaweza kuwa katika hali ya kumtumikia Bwana.
And I give them opportunities.
Nawapatia nafasi.
And I also help them handle the problems in their life.
Na kuwasaidia vile wanaweza kusuluhisha shida katika maisha yao.
And train them.
Na kuwafundisha.
And give them opportunities to serve God.
Na kuwapatia nafasi kwa ajili ya kutumikia Mungu.
And see how they're doing.
Na kuona vile wanafanya.
And I challenge them to go higher.
Na ninawatia changamoto kwamba wakaweze kuenda juu kuliko mahali wako.
So this is something I keep doing.
Hiyo ni kitu ambayo yeye huendelea kufanya.
Even when I go to the mission field.
Hata kama ako kwa uwanja kama huu.
When I come across pastors.
Anapokutana na mchungaji.
Or leaders.
Ama viongozi.
I would do the same.
Nitafanya vile ninafanya sasa hivi.
Encourage them to build up a strong relationship with God.
Wafundisha kuwa na uhusiano ulio wa msingi mzuri na Mungu.
And how to do a better job.
Na vile wanaweza kufanya kazi iliyo bora.
To change people's life.
Kubadilisha maisha ya watu.
To raise them up to serve God.
Kuwainua kumtumikia Mungu.
Okay.
Amen.
Now, do you have any question? Okay. The question is, if I train my people to serve God and then I go away on mission field and then they come against me.
Yes.
Okay. Now, if I come across people in the ministry that are, you know, have some life problem.
Anapokutana na watu katika huduma kwamba wako na shida za kimaisha.
That is something I must for sure take care of.
Hiyo ni kitu ambayo lazima achukulie manani.
But I always approach it in a positive way.
Lakini anachukulia manane kwa njia iliyo na busara.
I don't think of them being rebellious first.
Hawaoni kwamba hao watu ni waasi kwanza.
I just think of them having weaknesses.
Anaona kwamba hao watu wana udhaifu tu wa kimawazo ama ya kimipango.
The first thing I do, I want to find out what happened.
Kila kitu yeye atafanya, atatangulia kujua kwamba ni nini hii iliyofanyika.
Now, before that, I would say, in my teaching in general,
katika mafundisho yake kwa ujumla,
I always talk about the qualities of the workers of God.
Anasema kwamba kuna sehemu ambayo huwa inaangalia yale majukumu ama ile umuhimu ulio ndani ya mtumishi wa Mungu.
And I have this simple teaching.
Haya ni mafundisho tu ya rahisi tu.
We are all building on the foundation of Jesus Christ.
Wote tunajenga kwa msingi wa Yesu Kristo.
When people have pride or fighting,
watu wakiwa kwamba wako na kiburi ama wanapigana,
while they are building on a foundation,
wakati wanaendelea kujenga kwa msingi,
all the hard work will be in waste.
Kile chote ambaye kitakuwa kinaharibika.
Everything they do, you know, God doesn't like.
Kile chochote watakuwa wanafanya, Mungu hata kikubali, hata kipenda.
So I tell them, we all want to take care of our life's problems.
So unawaambia kwamba ni lazima sisi wenyewe tuchukue majukumu kwa ajili ya maisha yetu.
If not, you work so hard.
Kwamba unafanya kazi kwa bidii.
And all this is not remembered by God.
Na hii haiwezi kukumbukwa na Mungu.
Now some people will go to zero.
Sasa kile kitu kitatoka kwa 60 kikuja kwa sifuri.
Some people go to negative.
Inaenda kwa kutokuwa na umuhimu wote.
That God will say that your life doesn't show that you are a Christian.
Sasa Mungu atasema kwamba maisha yako haionekani kwamba wewe ni Mkristo.
If some people cause a church to be split,
watu wengine wakifanya kanisa kwamba limegawanyika,
there's something wrong with this Christian life.
Hiyo ni mambo ambayo yanaleta shida katika maisha ya Ukristo.
Now when this is serious, when the life, the problem is serious,
kati shida hii inaonekana kwamba imeongezeka ama imezidi,
the person could lose salvation.
Basi huyu mtu anaweza kupoteza wokovu wake.
So I would teach this in general.
Kwa hivyo tunafundisha haya mambo kwa ujumla.
And I myself set an example.
Na mimi mwenyewe ninatoa mfano.
They can see that if anyone is against me,
iwapo mtu yoyote ako kinyume na mimi,
I always handle it in a peaceful way.
Haya mambo huwa naisuluhisha kwa njia ya upole, njia ya amani.
They can see that I don't handle people's problem with anger.
Wanaona kwamba sisuluhishi matatizo ya watu nikiwa nimekasirika.
Because if I handle things with anger, that means I'm not taking care of my own life problem.
Kwa hivyo inaonekana kwamba iwapo ninasuluhisha shida za watu nikiwa na hasira, inaonekana kwamba mimi mwenyewe sijali maisha yangu.
So people see in different situation that I'm not affected by people.
Watu wanaona katika utafauti kwamba mambo ya watu hayaniadhiri mimi.
I continue to bless people.
Ninaendelea kubariki watu.
I continue you to be gentle.
Nina endelea kwamba mimi niwe mpole.
Okay, now after all these teachings,
baada ya mafundisho haya yote,
if someone is against me,
iwapo mtu yoyote ako kinyume na mimi,
now generally other people will tell me. Other people will tell me what happened.
Kama una uhusiano mzuri na watu wengine watakwambia ni nini ilifanyika.
Because they see that this person can hurt the group.
Sababu wanaona kwamba huyu mtu anaweza kuadhiri kikundi.
So I would approach this person and listen to that person.
Kwa hivyo nitafikia huyu mtu na nimuulize maswali.
And in the process when I handle the problem,
na ninapokuwa kwamba ninasuluhisha hii shida,
I continue to be gentle.
Ninaendelea kuwa mpole.
And also very often I'll bring in my wife.
Na hata pia ninaweza kuandamana pamoja na mke wangu.
Because for instance, if I'm about to send a message to one of these person,
kwa hivyo iwapo niko karibu kutuma ujumbe kwa ajili mmoja kwa watu hawa,
I send it to my wife first.
Ninaituma hii ujumbe, anaituma kwa mke wake kwanza.
I ask my wife, what I say, is what I say good or not?
Na arebo mkasu wembo jikuwa dino nemba neri nyalogureba maloba.
Would it create any unnecessary bad feelings?
Italeta kutengana kokote katika maisha.
I thank God. My wife is very sharp in that.
Kazuena yeno mdaiho, sharuwe italeta.
And I'm willing to listen to her.
Na anasikiliza yale mambo mka anasema.
So I try to handle with the person.
Sasa anajaribu kusuluhisha pamoja na mtu.
If it doesn't work out,
na kama hiyo jambo halitafanya kazi,
then I have to bring in other people to handle that.
Sasa langa kwa mandu mandi tiko niweze kubosa kuhuli kuhuli kuhuli.
Then I'll be following Matthew 18.
Na atafuata kitabu cha Mathayo 18.
I cannot allow someone to break up the group.
Hawezi kuruhusu mtu kwamba akaweze kufunja kikundi.
It's not for my glory.
Sio kwa utukufu wake.
It's not that I want people to submit to me.
Sio kwamba anataka tu watu wampende na kusema wote pastor ulimlai.
But I want the group to be following God in every way.
Taka kikundi kiweze kumfuata Mungu kwa kila njia iliyo bora.
So I will, you know, I never will run away from any problem.
Yesi yero hango munu mbo bani shida za.
That I will always face it.
Kwa hivyo yeye ukumbana na hilo jambo.
But at the same time I keep telling the person.
Lakini anaendelea kuambia huyu mtu kwamba hii mambo unafanya hii sikarerulia nyenye saa hata.
I care about you, I want the best to happen to you.
Ninajali kile kinaweza kutendeka kwa ajili yako.
Every time I say God bless you.
Au kila wakati namuombea ngo umama akukazi pano kuna mabandu.
If you just do what I suggest. If you just do what I suggest.
Ukifanya kitu kilio sawa.
What he suggests.
That what I suggest to the person to change.
Oh. Anapochukua kwamba kunalo jambo ambalo anapendekeza kwamba mtu abadilishe.
I'll be very happy.
Atakuwa ako na furaha.
And I can forget about the past.
Na anasahau mambo ya nyuma jana.
But if I notice wow. This person.
Na ninapotambua kwamba mtu huyu.
If he says he agrees,
kwamba hayuko tayari kukubali.
But he doesn't do what he says.
Lakini hafanyi kile kitu ambacho anasema.
Or when he does what he says.
Na anapofanya kile kitu amesema.
He has negative emotions.
Ako na nia ambazo sio nzuri.
That I or some other people can see the sadness on that person's face.
Watu wanaweza kuangalia na waone huzuni ya huyu mtu katika uso wake.
Or anger.
Ama hasira yake.
I will handle it.
Basi hiyo nitakumbana nayo.
But I will not handle it harshly.
Lakini sio kwamba atasuluhisha hilo jambo akiwa amekuwa mkali hata sura imebadilika kama.
I will let the person know I really, you know, I care about you.
Hey, atafanya huyu mtu ajue kwamba kweli huyu mchungaji anamjali yeye.
I want the best to happen to you.
Anataka kwamba mema yakaweze kutendeka kwa ajili ya huyu mtu.
Now if I notice the person has life problems.
Na akikundua kwamba huyu mtu ana uongo, kunenda msanje maana ababei kabisa.
For sure I will not raise him up to a higher level.
Shieto kumuye na kushiwango shikuluta.
I have to wait for him to change.
Eh, yezo kumbolo mundu na ye kaloga sie kwanza.
So I treasure inequalities more than ability to serve.
Anaangalia kwa yale mambo yaliyo ndani ya mtu kwa ajili ya matokeo mazuri.
Because inequalities are more important.
Kwa sababu kwa mambo yaliyo ndani yako na muhimu sana.
Okay. Okay. Now, I give you the biblical support to raise up people to serve God.
Anakupatia misingi ya kibiblia kwa ajili ya kuinua watu katika huduma.
And God has given me, you know, ways to make things simple and systematic.
Na Mungu ananipatia mipangilio kwa ajili ya kufanya vitu kuwa rahisi na vilio katika mipangilio mizuri.
I think when things are simple and systematic, people can remember it better.
Vitu vikiwa rahisi na katika mipangilio, watu wanaweza kukumbuka vizuri.
And then to encourage people to serve God or to have better spiritual life.
Kwa ajili ya kutia watu moyo kwa ajili ya kumtumikia Mungu na kuishi katika atua za kiroho.
I have 5 points.
Ako na mambo matano.
It's like a house.
Ijunga inzu. Sharama shaitu.
And on top.
Na yukulubu yenu.
Hallelujah.
On top, the first point is, everything is in God's hand and no one can run away.
Eh. Bubulishindu, shirimukono kwenye sae, na abulawunye lukwili kuhunda mukono kwenye sae.
Now this is very important.
Lilo ni jambo ambalo ni la maana sana.
Many people don't want to serve God.
Watu wengi hawataki kumtumikia Mungu.
Or love God.
Hata kumpenda Mungu.
Because they think I can wait.
Sababu walangambo ombi ni ndakwambia jambo mwaka kunakuwe.
God will not see me.
Mungu hataniona.
I can escape God's eyes.
Hata ninaweza kuepa kutoka kwa macho ya Mungu.
I can wait until the last moment to serve God.
Ninaweza kungojea mpaka wakati wa mwisho ndio nimtumikie Mungu.
Many people think they can cheat God.
Watu wengine ufikiria kwamba ati unaweza kumdanganya Mungu.
And many people think they can make God think that they are good Christians.
Ati abantu bani paparangambu wanyalo kona nyasaya aparimbu bani namareba malai.
But the point is, God sees every of our heart. He sees what is inside us. Whether you really love God or love to be noticed by people, or just love to have many people that follow you. Now many people serve God with unwillingly and they don't realize that they have ulterior motives. They like people to say, "Oh, Pastor, you're so good. You're the best pastor." Now, if people say that to you, it's great. The point is, what do you think inside? Do you think you are great? Or do you see that it's God who made me great? Originally, I was nothing. Even now, I'm nothing. It's God changed my life. And God gave me the ability to serve God. We cannot escape His eyes. Now, God has taught me many times.
Hallelujah.
When I have a little pride. Like when I pray for people and people
engineer.
Like when I pray for people and people experience the Holy Spirit. And then in my heart I say, "Oh, I have strong anointing." Immediately I say, "God doesn't like that. I don't want to think about that. I want to say I'm nothing. And God wants to use me." Now, I have seen people who pray for other people. And they push people. So when they pray and their head go back a little bit, they won't let go.
Hey,
and they go back, never let go. Yeah. And now, I'm not saying every one of these do it out of pride.
They are agreeing that what you are saying is true.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
But you interpret, please.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I'm...
But, you know, I'm not saying every case it must be our pride. Because there are some people, you know, they pray for people and hit very hard. And there's strong anointing coming over. But the person will fall down. Now, for myself, I avoid doing that. Because I don't want anyone to think that I'm pushing them to fall down. But I heard people have told me, when one famous evangelist prayed for a group of people, he was pushing very hard on each person. Now, I'm not judging. But I'm saying, don't do things to show people. Don't do things to show people I'm more powerful. Because God sees our heart. God sees our heart. When God doesn't like our heart, everything we do is in vain.
Mm-hmm.
So this first point is very important. Everything is in God's hand, and no one can run away. Psalm 24:1. Every time you say a verse, you can say it twice.
Okay. Saburi Ishirinaine Unyanuranga.
Okay. And then the earth is the Lord's and everything in it. So everything in the world belongs to the Lord. Including our lives. If God wants to take away our life, we can do nothing. And even if the doctor says we are dying, if God really wants to save you, he can do it. Everything is in God's hand. No one can run away. In Chinese, there's an expression. The chicken running away. That is saying that you lose your opportunity. But you know that your chicken cannot run away from you. Every day it has to come home. So we cannot run away from God. And then Revelation
2:23.
There it says in the second part that I am he who searches hearts and minds. I will repay each of you according to your deeds. He will search your heart. But for God, it's not hard at all.
Hallelujah.
It's not hard to search our hearts. People might have problems searching other people's hearts. But God sees you instantly. And he'll reward us according to our deeds. So when we really love God, God is really happy. And God will reward you. And God will raise you up. So for me, I always want to say, yes, Lord, help me. That I really love God. I do everything to love God. I do everything to love people. I don't have to think about what I get back. Actually, the ministry I do now, I do it all for free.
Yeah.
Including ministry in Hong Kong.
Hong Kong.
I don't receive any salary. I do it all for free. God has repaid me back so much. I don't mind paying the price at all. Okay. So the first point is everything is in God's hand and no one can run away. And I hope we all will watch our life and see, is there anything God doesn't like? Do I have any pride? Do I have any negative feelings? Do I despise some people? Do I despise some teachings? Do I look down on other pastors? Do I want to take advantage of people? And we know that everything God sees. But we can serve with joy. And say, if I just serve God with a simple heart, just want to love God and love people, and God will bless me. I've seen pastors stealing people from other churches. Now, sometimes I think, do the pastors think about we have to stand in front of God one day? Some people seem not to think about it at all. They just want my church to be full of people. Whatever way I get people to come, it doesn't matter. But God sees our heart. Okay, now the next point. Next 2 points about blessings.
The
second point is following and obeying God will bring blessings. And then the third point is serving God will bring reward. And then the left side, the negative side, living in sins will bring destruction. And then the fifth point, not serving God will bring destruction. So this is very simple. Everything is God's hand and we cannot run away. If we love God and follow God, He will bless us. If we serve God, He will reward us. If we don't follow God, it will bring destruction. If we don't serve God, it will bring destruction. So if people really believe that, then I'll say, do you want to go destruction, the way of destruction? Or do you want to be used by God? And then God is happy with you. Now, many people have schizophrenia, split personality. So split faith. You know, Christians basically believe God is almighty and loving. All the blessings are in God's hands. But somehow people will say, I run my way. Yeah. I run my life in my own way. And I will escape God's eyes. And I can still get blessings in the world. For instance, if they see an attractive person with the opposite sex in front of them, they'll be tempted and forget everything about God. Thinking that God cannot see them. Or they can run away from God's eyes. But actually, everything we do, God sees. If we follow God, God will bless us. Like you see how God has blessed me with a wonderful wife. Now I have her pictures everywhere. it's in a notebook too, but it's okay. Okay. So God has blessed me so much.
Mm-hmm.
Because God sees our heart. I don't want to lose anything God has given me. I don't want God to be unhappy with me. That's the teaching we want to tell people. Okay. So number 2 point. Following and obeying God will bring blessings. Matthew 6:33. Seek first His kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you. So when you really seek God's kingdom of grace, kingdom of salvation, you want more people saved, and also seek the kingdom of lordship. Now you can write this down, the three kingdoms.
Kingdom of lordship.
Lordship.
Oh.
Now
it's the same kingdom but two angles. So first I want more people saved. And in the kingdom of lordship, that where Jesus is the Lord, there is His kingdom. I'm sorry to say that some churches Jesus may not be Lord. Mm-hmm. In some kingdom, Jesus may not be the Lord.
Mumakanisa kandi, Yesu shalumu onyeta.
The pastor might be the Lord. Or some elders or deacons are the Lord. And in many families, Jesus is not the Lord.
Yes.
But the bossy husband or bossy wife is the boss. But you say, Lord, I want you to be my Lord totally. In my inner life, in my family life, in my family, I would not be speaking, you know, in a rough way. I'm always gentle to my spouse. And we want to build a God-loving family. In a church, I'm not controlling people. I'm guiding them and blessing them. Wherever I go, I do what the Lord wants me to do. That way, Jesus is our Lord. I invite you to think about your life. Is Jesus your Lord in your family?
Yes,
I have to say that some ministers, they're powerful at church. But in the home, he has a lot of anger. He has not let Jesus be the Lord. And then the third kingdom is the kingdom of glory.
King
of glory. That you want Jesus to come back. That you want to prepare for Jesus' second coming. And then we'll enter the kingdom of glory. So if we really seek the kingdom of God, we want more people saved. We want Jesus to take over our life. And then we want to prepare for Jesus' second coming. All these things will be added to us. Do you believe this? Now, if you believe it, you won't worry about anything.
No, but no, so better.
You will say, God knows my needs, He will provide for me. Now, many Christians are weak because they worry, do I have money? Because they don't believe this verse. That Jesus knows who are faithful. And He will bless each one according to your faithfulness. But of course it's grace. It's not because what we do good, therefore God bless us. When God blesses us, it's grace. But the people who don't follow God, God cannot come into their life. Some Christians say, I believe in Jesus. How come my family has so many fights? Because they have not handled their anger. So what this says is that if we follow God, God will bless us. In Psalm 34, verse 10, the lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord will lack no good thing.
Repeat that statement. The lion,
okay.
Yes.
In English or?
In English.
It's powerful.
Okay.
It's a powerful one.
Okay. The lion may grow weak and hungry. But those who seek the Lord lack no good thing.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Because God has every resource in his hand. All the blessings are in his hands. He can give you any blessings. He can even raise people from the dead. You just follow him. But you say, not my will. If God doesn't raise the dead this time, it's okay. I submit to God. Whenever he wants to do it, I keep praying for dead people when I
see.
But I don't feel bad if the dead person doesn't rise. But I always look for the time when he will raise the dead.
Yes.
Because I believe that God has the best timing. Like, for instance, for my teaching now. I thank God that God taught me so many things. And I
just
want to say, I'm nothing. God chose me when I was weak.
Yes,
when I've sinned many times. But God chose me. And let me experience His Holy Spirit. And change me. And then give me many teachings. He download teachings to me all the time. I thank God for that. But as to how to use it, where to go, I leave it to God. Because I trust God has the best plan. I just trust in God. Have a good relationship with him and obey him. And obey him. And trust in him. Have a good relationship with him. Obey him in every way. He will for sure bless me and guide my way. So I'm very relaxed. I don't have to worry about my future. I just say, God, I don't know how many years I have. You just teach my life. And give me teachings. And open the way where to go, when to go. I know that he will plan it for me. God is the best planner. So I serve God with freedom and joy. And you notice when I preach, I'm relaxed.
Hallelujah.
Because I know God is working. God is touching your heart. So when I follow God, God will bless us. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen.
Okay, the third point. Serving God will bring reward.
Mark 9:41.
Marco. Anyone who gives a cup of water to in my name because you belong to the Christ will certainly not lose the reward. So if we give a cup of water to one because it belongs to the Lord, we will not lose our reward.
Yes.
That's easy, isn't it? That's easy.
Yes.
You just want to bless people,
yes.
Then you get reward.
Yes.
But when we are proud,
yes.
When we are proud,
yes.
Then we won't, then God doesn't like it. then we will not get a reward. You know, it's so simple. Anyone can do it.
Yes.
Some people say, I don't have spiritual gifts. I tell them, you just come and smile at the people. You give smile to a little one. You care about them. You pray for them. And visit them. And bring people to Christ. When you do it out of a heart to say, I love God. And I love the people. God will for sure reward you. Jesus said, you by no means lose your reward. So it's very easy for the simple-minded. For one who loves God, everything you do is remembered by God. So that motivates people to serve God. And then in Matthew 25:23. And then the master said, you are good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I'll put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. So when we serve God, God remembers it. And come in and share your master's happiness. And then in Luke 7:38. Give and it will be given to you. A good measure.
Yes.
Pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Now this verse talk about if you give, give to people and to God. Because of love for God, and then God will reward you with good measure. A lot will be given to you. And then press down and shaken together and running over so the blessings will come so much will be given to you. So now this encourages people to give their time and service to people. And then the blessings will be poorer unto them. Now, do you believe God totally? If you believe God totally, what He says He will do. But many people say, the money in my wallet is safer. When I have the money, I can buy things. When I give the money, the money is gone. When we look, you know, when we believe what we see. But when we believe what God says, we'll see when we give, more will be given to us. But we don't give in order to get. We give because we love God. And we thank God. And to bless and want to bless people. So when people have this heart, they'll be willing to give. And whatever they give, God will remember. Okay, now, the fourth point. Living in sins will bring destruction. Now remember, the right side, when we follow God, love God, then we'll be blessed. And here on this side, living in sin will bring destruction. Galatians 6:8. Whoever sows to please the flesh from the flesh will reap destruction. Now recently, I heard of one young man who has sex with different... Now he's a Christian. He said he's a Christian. He has sex with different women.
Come again.
I know a Christian man who has sex with different Christian women. And he is chasing after And he is chasing after another girl, Christian girl. He's chasing after another Christian girl. He's chasing after a Christian girl. And he said, I have repented. And he asked to have sex with the woman. He said, I made up my mind to marry you so we can have sex now. And he also said, I already said to God, I repent. So the pastor doesn't have to talk to me. The pastor doesn't have to talk to me about my sin in the past. He has this wrong concept. When seven sins and asks Jesus to forgive, then he doesn't have to face the consequence of that sins. Now, when we truly repent, God will forgive us. But it doesn't mean we don't have to face the consequence of the sins. Like David, when he repented of his sin of adultery and killing the person, God forgave him, but then God said, the sword will not leave your family. There is punishment from God. You know, this man has hurt a few women. He has hurt a few women by having sex with them. And he thought, I just asked Jesus to forgive me. All the consequence will be erased. And the pastor doesn't have to talk to him. Now this is a very wrong concept. For every sin there is a consequence. Now when we ask Jesus to forgive us, He forgives us. For instance, if someone is angry with someone, and then he says, I'm sorry. But still this person has been hurt. There is some damage to this person. And damage to the relationship. And damage to our relationship with God. And damage to our joy and peace. So we have to tell people, when they don't obey God, there must be destruction. There is destruction to different degree. When we are building on the foundation of Jesus, after we build it, do you want to break it down? Do you want to tear down everything you have done for God? If you tear down everything, you have nothing. And that is what happened when we sin. And don't follow God. Now how to overcome sins? How to overcome sins? Whenever there is any sinful thought in our mind that you are aware, first you can write this down, 5 steps of victory. When you are aware of sinful thoughts, and then you believe it's destructive. You write this down, this is very helpful. So first is aware. Second is destructive. And then three is Bible. Use the Bible to apply to a situation. What should I do? So what, according to the Bible, what should I do? And number four, pray. Number five, choose to obey. Now I want to say, before I experience the Holy Spirit, many times I have sinful thoughts. And I said, it's okay that I sinned this time. And I asked God to forgive me later. But now I know that every sin would have destruction. It would take away the strong presence of God. God would not like me so much. It can also ruin my ministry. So anytime there are sinful thoughts, when I'm aware of it, I say this is destructive. It can destroy my life. And then I use biblical principle. What should I do? I should forgive. I should bless the person. I don't have to be affected by the person. And then I pray. Lord, help me. Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Lord, the Lord gives me strength. And then I choose to obey. Then I don't say, I don't feel. Some people say, it's unfair, I don't want to forgive the person. But I say, if I don't forgive, I myself will be hurt. If I lust after a woman, I will be hurt. If I lust after a woman, I will be hurt. If I'm proud, I'm hurt. So I have the motivation to take care of every sin in my life. Now this is very simple. It's not very hard. So long as you believe that sin is destructive. So the fifth point is, not serving God will bring destruction. Matthew 25:26. The master said, you wicked, lazy servant. And then verse 30. And throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. So when the servant buried his treasures, his gifts, the servant, the three servants, five talents, two talents and one talent, and the servant of one talent buried that,
God
would say, you are wicked and lazy servant. Throw him in the outer darkness. Is that heaven?
That's not heaven.
Is it heaven? Throw in the darkness?
No.
No.
You know, there are many people, they go to church, and they bury their spiritual gifts. Or when they do what they don't do what Jesus told them to do to the other people. When they don't do it to the little ones, they'll be cast into eternal punishment. There will be many people in the church. They think they've gone to church many years. And they think for sure they can go to heaven. Or for sure they will receive reward. But they might find that one day Jesus said, I don't know you, you wicked and lazy
servant.
You have not done to one of these little ones. So when you hear these 5 points, now it's for you and for your people. Now it's something you don't just teach in one time, but you keep telling them. Let me go through the 5 points again. First point, everything is in God's hand and no one can run away. But many people think they can run away from God. But we cannot. And then on the right hand side, the second point is, following and obeying God will bring blessings. And then the third point is, serving God will bring reward. And then the fourth point, living in sin will bring destruction. And then number five, not serving God will bring destruction. So it's very simple and clear. And so I present this to people. Do you think you can run away from God? If you follow God, you'll be blessed. Every little thing you do for God, God will remember and reward you. Even when you do little things. But when you don't follow God and sin, you have destruction. And when you don't serve God, and one day God say you are lazy and wicked servant, it will be terrible. So I encourage all people to serve God. And when you serve God, you'll be joyful and full of strength and enjoy serving God. And you see people saved and you say it's so wonderful to serve God. So God bless you all. That you'll be able to raise up people, discern the ones who really have the heart to serve God. We want to raise up everyone to serve God. But there are people who really have a good heart. There are people who have big potentials. Raise up these people. And God will be very happy with you. And you'll be very happy with yourself. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
So do you have the confidence to raise up people to serve God?
Yes.
Have you found someone in your church who is willing?
Yes.
You can raise them up to a higher level. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now you can go online, YouTube or Facebook. Go online to YouTube or Facebook.
I am.
And look for Pastor Yip, Y-I-P.
Y-I-P. Y-I-P. Pastor Yip.
There are Chinese videos, but there are also English videos. And so you can watch it yourself, and you can send the links to your members,
and
it will encourage people and raise up people to serve God. Hallelujah. And then we all say, we can do great things for God. I can raise up people for God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I can raise up an army for God. And God is very happy with what I do. Hallelujah.